Ooh, good question. Susan Jack 62. What do you think would have made the biggest difference for you when you were growing up so that maybe those high school years wouldn't have been so hard? I would definitely say like support. I had a lot of self-confidence in my ability to achieve certain things, but I had very poor self-esteem, very low self-esteem. I always thought I was very unattractive. I never thought anyone was interested in dating me. And because of being trans and growing up at the time I did and where I did, I thought there was something wrong with me. I thought I was broken. I thought I was unlovable. I had a really poor self-esteem and self-worth. And I think having support in my life, whether it was my parents, friends, environment I was in, all would have played a huge role in changing those things. Susan Jack 62 also asks, how did Olivia get to be so freaking amazing? You know, I don't know, Susan. I would like to know that too, but I totally agree. Gothic Beauty 3, what is your motivation for working out even when you don't want to? For me, it was just all about my goals. Winning for me was like the biggest high I could have in life. You know, certain championships, breaking certain records, those were huge motivators for me. And then the other biggest motivators were I always had people doubting me. Always had people telling me that I couldn't accomplish the things I wanted to. And that existed all throughout my life. Even when I got to the highest levels, still had people, you know, doubting I could come back from an injury or that I had the ability to win, you know, the world championship or break the world record. And a big part of my motivation as well was proving all those people wrong, proving all the doubters, proving all the haters. When I was really, on those days I was exhausted and didn't feel like being in the gym. And, you know, there were times I did crazy things like breaking into the gym in the middle of the night to train. And when I was doing those type of things, I would think about all the people that said I couldn't achieve what I set out to do, and all the people that said I would never be able to do it, and that helped motivate me. But my primary motivator was just to achieve my goals, achieve the things that were important to me and the things I'd wanted to do, you know, since I was, you know, young, and those were the driving force. So whenever I felt wavering, I would think about, you know, the goals I had set and why I wanted to achieve them, all the work I had put in and what it meant to me. Swizzy stuff asks, what makeup brands are your favorite and what facial cleansers do you use? Rodin and Fields are the facial cleansers I use. I use their facial scrub in the shower frequently, and that I feel that really helps not only clear up my skin but make it smoother. My favorite makeup brands, I would say MAC is definitely one of them, especially all my lip colors. All my lip liners and lipsticks are MAC. Eyeshadow, Urban Decay, I have a lot of Urban Decay eyeshadows. My foundation's also MAC. Stila is my favorite eyeliner. Mascara, I've tried about every brand out there. Currently using a Kat Von D, and then I also use Chubby Lash when I want a more natural look. Wingets ask, why do you have a girlfriend and not a boyfriend? Very simple, I'm more attracted to girls than I am boys. Moja Darcy 1 asks, what would you say to the young kids out there that are struggling with their identity? My advice would be just to realize that anytime somebody says anything negative or hateful towards you, realize that's a reflection of who they are, not who you are. No matter how hard things are and how dark they seem, they will get better. It's very easy to feel like things are hopeless and they're never gonna get better, and I've been there. And I know what that feels like. Keep toughing things out. Life is not going to be that way forever. And when you look back, sometimes you'll even be thankful for the tough times because the adversity makes us stronger. Realize you're important, valid, and loved no matter who you are. Matisha Hu Poo asks, when you get negative comments, how do you not let them bother you? You know, it's a big thing is just recognizing, number one, when people say terrible things about you, it's a reflection of who they are. These people, like, you know, hiding behind a keyboard in some other part of the world, they would never say the same stuff to your face. And it's really, and then some people say things just to get a rise out of you. Recognize that allowing that negativity into your life and allowing that to upset you isn't going to help anything, isn't going to help you. It's much better to focus on the positive, let those things go, and just recognize them for what they are. Like, why am I going to let some person I don't know, probably would never respect, you know, probably knows nothing about me, nothing about being trans, nothing about the struggles I've been through. Why am I going to let a little comment, anonymous comment from some keyboard warrior halfway across the world, why am I going to let that ruin my day? All right, everyone, thanks for watching my video. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe if you found it valuable, and let your friends know if you think it's something they'd enjoy too. Hope everyone has a great day. Thanks, guys.